Hey, so today we're going to take a look at the power of audit templates and what they can do for you in terms of auditing and reducing the false positive and reducing the noise inside of your application. So you can see here on my screen, I have a test application that I utilize, and you can see there's a number of releases here that have a bunch of different critical issues inside. So for our purposes, we're going to go ahead and take a look at our Contoso Air app today. And I'm going to go directly into my issues. So most likely you've seen issues like this inside of your own applications, and you're looking at them and often saying, okay, what am I going to do with these particular applications? And what am I going to do with these issues? And I have, critical issues and I have high issues. How do I manage all of these things? So one of the things that we've done inside of Fortify On Demand is give you a quick, easy ability to be able to do this. So for instance, this one is pretty common. It's password management. So we can see here that there's an empty password inside of this. It may compromise security, but let's just assume that for our purposes today, I already trust this. It's supposed to be like this. I've checked with my developers and hey, we're not going to fix it. It's just part of what it is. What I could do is actually create what we call an audit filter. So this cr gives me the ability to go ahead and pick this out right inside of the issue as I'm auditing, and it's going to grab down all the necessary filters for me. So it's going to say, okay, based on this category, password management equals empty for this particular rule. We're going to set this, the severity is high, and all the different things that happen. It also shows where the issue contains in the file of the actual application, the sync, which is the file access, and then the package, which is really JavaScript core. And I can do a couple different things with this audit template here. So one, I can suppress it. So I could just hide it so I never see this again. Or I can actually set the severity to another level. So let's say for instance, this is just a low thing. I want to maintain it. I want some audit record of it, but I don't necessarily need my developers to look at it on a regular basis. And if it's high, they're going to continue to keep looking at it. So I'm going to go ahead and set the severity to low. And I'm going to go ahead and click create my filter. So now the next time that I run this application, if I run a new scan on it, what it's going to do is automatically look at that rule and then apply the filter and actually set the severity back to low. That way it's not coming up every single time. While I still have an audit record of it showing up in the lows, it's now just not addressable as a high. So I'm going to go ahead and click close. So And I can also show you a way we can also go and double check this as well to make sure that it was created, or if we want to manage those rules later on as well. So what we've done here is we've kind of come back out. So if I go back into my application after we've set up our audit template and I go back into audit tools here on the bar, I can see here that we've actually set up an application audit template for Jarvis. And we can see here all that we can see here the empty password, we can see here the rule that it applies to, and it actually goes through the process of creating this automatically. Now, if I ever wanted to come in here and edit this rule, I could do that. I could also add additional rules if I want to do that as well and save them. So that way, anytime I run this scan on this particular application, all these rules are going to apply and save me a lot of the troubles of going through and auditing each individual issue every single time. So I hope that helps in kind of streamlining your auditing process for your particular applications. Until next time, see you then.